Spain's government advances a transgender rights bill, allowing anyone over 16 to easily change gender on their ID documents. The proposed law effectively simplifies the procedure for changing gender on official documents, dropping the requirement for a medical report attesting to gender dysphoria or proof of hormonal treatment. It allows applicants to request a change on a basis of a simple statement. They will also be able to change their given name. The move comes on the eve of International Pride Day. If adopted, the legislation will make Spain one of the few countries in Europe to permit gender self-determination. Spain's equality minister says the bill will be brought to Parliament before the summer. In the U.S., three people are dead and more than 200 others injured after a long-distance train derailed in Missouri. The Amtrak train was traveling from Los Angeles to Chicago when it struck a dump truck on a public crossing. The crossing involved does not have boom gates, and a local fire official says accidents in the area are not uncommon. The derailment comes a day after another Amtrak-operated train collided with a passenger vehicle at a railroad crossing in California, resulting in three deaths. Several ranking Philippine agriculture and customs officials tagged as protectors and smugglers of agricultural products. The identities of the officials were revealed in an intelligence report forwarded to Senate President Tito Soto more than a month after the Senate Committee of the Whole ended its investigation on the nonstop entry of smuggled agricultural goods in the country. The list of accused includes Customs Commissioner Leonardo Guerrero and Agriculture Undersecretary Ariel Cayanan. It also tagged a certain Mayor Jun Jamante and Toby Tianco. Senator Soto says he's saddened by Tianco's inclusion, but said it's also possible that person may not be the Navotas mayor, just someone who shares the same name. Tianco has also denied being involved in smuggling, claiming syndicates may be behind his inclusion after he himself filed smuggling complaints and ordered the conduct of a series of raids on smuggled products. He adds he is ready to face the Senate if the upper chamber wants to reopen the investigation. Meanwhile, Agriculture Secretary William Dar asks the public to give the named DA officials the chance to present their side. A court in the Philippine province of Tarlac dismisses the initial charges against a group of farmers and activists who were arrested over a land dispute. A Capas municipal judge dropped the illegal assembly charge, citing conflicting statements as to whether the so-called Tinang 83 were armed. The court also junked a malicious mischief complaint against them. It said prosecutors failed to prove that the group damaged property out of hatred, revenge, or ill motive. The court also noted that jurisdiction over the land dispute should lie with the Agrarian Reform Department. The Tinang 83 were arrested earlier this month for allegedly damaging a disputed sugar plantation. The government data later showed the farmers in the group were the rightful owners of the land. A lawyer for the Tinang 83 welcomes the Capas court ruling. But attorney Joe Clemente says their legal battle continues as 3 to 5 other charges are pending against the group. The Philippine Health Department reported 867 new cases Monday, the country's highest daily tally in over 3 months. The number of active cases has breached 7,000 and is the highest since April 30th. The Philippines averaged 662 new daily cases from June 20th to the 26th. Officials say this was 53% higher from the week before. Some 591 patients are in severe to critical condition. The health department also reports 51 deaths from that period. The hospital bed utilization rate was at 18.1%, while the ICU utilization rate was at 14.9%. Well, despite the increase in average number of daily cases, the Philippines' healthcare utilization rate remains low at just 14.9%. That's according to Private Hospital Association President Dr. Jose Rene Degrano. He says majority of the cases are either mild or asymptomatic and do not need hospitalization. He, however, warns the numbers may not be 100% accurate.
They treat it just like flu. And so they just try to observe it and then stay at home. And they do not want, of course, to go to the hospitals to be tested because, well, because it's very expensive, you know, to get an RT-PCR. The real number of cases probably double the figures that we are presenting right now, because a lot of people don't really get tested, and some that get tested by using the rapid antigen, it's not reported. The local government in this area should really monitor these things, you know, and then of course be more strict in the implementation of the minimum health protocols.
The Philippines postpones the rollout of COVID-19 booster shots for non-immunocompromised minors aged 12 to 17. It was supposed to have started over the weekend, but health officials say a recommendation from an independent advisory body prevented them from doing so. The Health Technology Assessment Council had said non-immunocompromised minors can only get boosted once an area reaches 40 to 70% booster coverage for all priority groups and the adult population. An advisor of President Duterte opposes this recommendation.
Yung age stack, sana they become more reasonable. Kasi itong mga 12 to 17 na kabataan natin, na may pasok ka na sa face-to-face this August, bumayag na sila sa pagbigay ng mga bakuna dito na first booster lang naman to. At ang bagal ang galaw ng age stack. Let's move faster.
There are many lessons that we have learned.
Meanwhile, former health secretary also wants the country to step up its booster drive.
I think that we should widen the eligibility of those who can receive booster shots at this point. I can see that there are millions of vaccines that are supposed to be expiring soon. I don't know why we should not be using these vaccines to protect our people.